Welcome back, friends. So here we are back to creating a quiz, and we will set the editing on, and under this topic I would like to create a quiz. Now already our questions are there in the question bank, so all we have to do is create a quiz and add the questions to it. So to do that, we will add an activity or resource. We'll click here and we will click on activities. So you will find that there all these options are here. We are going to add a quiz, so we will select quiz. So here this page looks familiar. You'll find that most of the pages where you are adding any activity or any resource, it'll have the similar format. So let me give a name to this. Let's call it demo quiz. Okay, and you can give a description. Say I'll just type, this is a demo quiz. So you can give some additional informations here for the quiz. Okay, next let us look at the timings option. If you click on timings, this will open up. So four options are here. Open the quiz. Now you can see that it is grayed out, so it is disabled. So to enable it, you have to click on this checkbox. Enable. Similarly, close the quiz also we will enable. So these two dates and times are for starting when, from which date and time onwards the quiz will be available to the students. So, and close the quiz, this will be the last date and time till which the quiz will be open. So you can enable them and give some date and time. So let me put it as 1st October closing, 1st October 2020, and it is here, and at the same time. So 24 hours will keep the quiz open. Okay, then comes time limit. So time limit, you want to give a particular time for the quiz, say 10 minutes or 15 minutes for the students to complete the quiz. So you have to enable and then you have to type it out here. Let me give 10 minutes for the quiz. Okay, so for any particular attempt, maximum time that will be allotted will be 10 minutes. Next is, when time expires, what should happen? Now you think of a student who is attempting the quiz and 10 minutes has expired, but the student has not submitted his or her answers. So in such a situation, what should happen? The default option is open attempts are submitted automatically. So if the user has not submitted, it will be submitted automatically. Then you have other options. If you just click here, you will get the other options here. Give a grace period, or you have very strict rules that if it expires, then if you have not submitted, time expires and you have not submitted, it will not be counted. So this you can will leave it at the default one. Then next comes grade. So you can specify what is the grade that is required to pass. Now this is optional. You may choose to keep, you may not choose to keep, it's up to you. What is important here is this two, this first and the second, the third and the fourth one. Attempts allowed. Now how many times do you want the student to give the quiz? Okay, so maybe first time the student has made a mistake, okay, unknowingly for whatever reason. So would you like to give a second attempt or anything? So if you select unlimited, then the student can keep on giving the quiz from the starting date to the end date, or you can restrict it by giving a number. So let me give 3 attempts. So we'll allow 3 attempts for the student to correct any mistakes. Now out of these 3, if I give more than one, then for each attempt the student will get some grades, will get some marks. Now out of these, which one will you consider? So 4 options are here: highest, average, first attempt and last attempt. So let me keep the highest. Okay, so that is under grade. Next, under layout. So layout, you can choose how many questions you want to show in one page. Okay, you may have every question in a different page, or you may have all the questions in one page, or you may have two questions in one page, and so on. So I will select, since I have my quiz is very small, I'm going to give only 4 or 5 questions, so all questions in one page. Now if you have very large number of questions, then you can choose to give the number of questions per page. So that's the layout. Rest, everything is okay. We will not look at any of these. These are not so important. You can leave it at their defaults. So now save and display. So you can see, this is the name of the quiz. This is the description that we have written. It's showing all these information. Attempts allowed is 3. Quiz opens at this date, this time. Quiz closes at this date, this time. Time limit is 10. And the highest grade is the one which will be used. But you can see that no questions have been added yet. So you may choose to add the questions later on. In that case, you can click on back to the course. You go back to the course. Or you may choose to click on edit quiz, which will allow you to add questions. Let us click on edit quiz. So now I'm here. I'm going to add questions to this quiz. So to do that, you can see you have this button out here, this link out here, add. So click on add, and then you can choose to add a new question. So you can add an individual question, but remember, this question will remain only in this quiz. You cannot use it for any other quiz. You have to type it out again. Or since we have already added the questions to the question bank, we will select from the question bank. So from the question bank, so when I click on question bank, I will get all the questions in the question bank will be displayed. So let me add some questions here. Question 1, question 2, 3, find the largest, find the smallest. Okay, true and false, I'll give this 6 questions. So you can select the questions that you want. Now click on add selected questions to the quiz. So now you can see I have how many? 6 questions in the quiz. So I may choose to, here you can see each of these contains 1 mark. Each of these questions are for 1 mark. So you can put the maximum grade. Since I have 6 questions, I'll put the maximum grade to 6. 6, and then save. So the questions are saved in the quiz. Alright, 6 questions, 1 mark each, total marks, maximum grade is 6. Okay, quiz is done. Now let us go back to the topic from the menu. So creating and using quiz. So I can see the demo quiz displayed out here. So now I would like to log in as a student and attempt this quiz, to give this quiz. So I will log out from here and log in as a student. So I have already created username for student. Student 1. So this is the student view of our course. So you can see this is the course. This is the course. I'll click here. So I am here. Now you may notice that there is no editing, turn editing on button on this portion, because the student cannot edit the course. The student can only access the resources and take part in the activities. So I have this demo quiz here. Let me click here. Okay, so here it shows me 3 attempts allowed. Do I want to attempt the quiz now? Yes. So it is showing me the some information that time limit is 10. Okay, so now I can attempt the quiz. So you can see on this side the time is being shown. How much time is left? So let me give this. Okay, let me choose some incorrect ones also. 50, 90. Okay. This one let me give correct. Okay, let me give this wrong. Then here, okay, let me give the correct answer. Okay, here let me give the correct answer. Here now I can give, I can choose more than one, so I have check boxes instead of radio buttons. Greater than 10, so I will make a mistake here. Okay, now finish attempt. So all the answers have been saved. Okay, now I can go back, still time is there, I can go back and review my questions, whether my answers that I given are correct or not, or I can choose to submit. So click on submit. Again, it will give you a confirmation. Submit and finish. So there, now you can see it is showing me how much I have scored. So I have scored 3.75 out of 60. This point is because of the match the following, because I could get only one correct. Okay, I couldn't get the others correct. Similarly, this one also I could get only one correct, one was wrong, so I got only half marks from here. So you can see how much marks I have got. It is showing 50% only I have got here. Here I have got one. This one is correct, I have got one. So you can see the grade is displayed out here. I can also see my grades from the grades option here from the menu. So demo quiz, I have grade of 3.75, which is 62.5%. So this is how the quiz can be used as a form of assessment of students.